let us start with the external CSS, right? External CSS means that we will create two separate files. One file that will act as having all the HTML coding. Second file we will create in which we will apply all the CSS properties. We will be applying all the CSS properties, right? Now, first of all, you will create the HTML web page file. In that file, you will create the coding. You will write all the necessary tags, but you will not do any formatting in that page. You will not do any formatting in that page. Then you will create one second file. In that second file, you will apply all the CSS properties on all the tags which you want to format. In nutshell, I want to tell you one thing: coding in a separate page and CSS formatting on the separate page. The file in which you have write the HTML code, you will save the file with HTML extension. I repeat my statement. In the file where you have created the HTML coding, you will save that file with HTML extension. Then the second file where you have created the CSS coding, you will save that file with extension .css. Later, you will link these two files. How to link these two files? With the help of link tag. You will use link tag in the head tag, inside the head tag of HTML web page. There you will apply a connection, a link to your CSS file. Later on, if you want to make any changes in the web page, you only have to make changes in the CSS file. Whatever formatting changes you will apply on CSS, automatically they will be applied on HTML file. So you have to make changes only on one file. Have I made myself clear up till here? You can raise your thumb if up till here I'm thoroughly clear to everybody. Now next, I'll be discussing few more properties with you people. Today I'll be discussing text related properties, how you can format your text. Then I'll be starting with the external style sheet coding, right? All right, first is text indent property. When you want to apply indentation to your text, then that time you use text indent property. And how to write this property? Text indent hyphenated word, then you give the value, any number in the form of pixels. You can give any number in the form of pixels, right? 30 pixel, 40 pixel, 25 pixel, 20 pixels as per your requirement. Next is text align. You want to do alignment of your text. You want your text to be appearing on the right side. You want your text to appear on the center. You want your text to appear as justify. Then you will apply this property, text align. And this property has four possible values: left, right, center, and justify. Right? Then text decoration. Now, when you want to underline your text, when you want your text to appear in the blinking form, when you want your text to appear as overline or line through, like a line is striking through your text, that time you use a very special property of text that is known as text decoration property. You write, you take the selector, take the tag onto which you want to apply this property, text decoration property, and write any value which you want. If you want to underline, your value will be underlined. If you want to make your text appearing as a blinking text, then you will give the value blinking text. Right? Now, word spacing. There are two properties, two very special properties, word spacing and letter spacing. What is the difference in the two? Word spacing means space between two words. How much space you want to give in between two words. Like I speak one sentence, this is my pen. Now this is one word, is one word. In between this and is, how much space you want to give? I give you example over here. I write one example here. Please see carefully. This is. Now see the gap between this is. See this gap. This gap is called word spacing. The more value you will give, the more space it will cover between the words. Now what is letter spacing? How much space you want to give in between the letters of the word. Like see here. This word has four letters. T-H-I-S. How much space you want to give in between letters? See this. Have you noticed? Have you noticed, everybody? Those who are very sincere and serious in the studies, their videos are always on. And this is what I notice in the lecture. This feature is letter spacing and this feature is word spacing. The more you will give the value, the more space it will occupy. Up till here, am I thoroughly clear? Any doubt to any child up till here? Okay, now I proceed further. Text transform, the last property of text. You want to change your text from lowercase to uppercase. You want to change your text from uppercase to lowercase. You want to capitalize your text. You want how your text should appear. That time you use this property. Text transform. If you are giving value uppercase, whether you have typed the coding in lowercase, suppose the sentence is this is my book, and you have typed this sentence in lowercase, but when you will see in the browser view, it will appear in the uppercase because you have applied the property text transform uppercase. Similarly, if you want that your text should appear in the lowercase, you give the value lowercase over here. Now, what is the what is capitalize? Capitalize means every first character of the word should be capital. Every first character of the word is capital. Rest are small. Like this is my book. This T capital, is I capital, A already capital. Book B capital. First letter of every word should be in capital. Now I show you the external CSS coding, how to create external style sheet. I told you if you want to create external style sheet, you have to create two different web pages. Then we will link these two web pages by a special tag that is known as link tag. This is the HTML web page. This is my first page which I have saved with .html extension. Right? Now, see here carefully. HTML tag. Then after HTML tag, I have taken head tag. Now inside the head tag, you have to create the link. You have to create the connection with the CSS page. You have to create the connection with the CSS page. How to create the connection? With the help of link tag. Link tag take three attributes. REL. REL means relation. Relation means the second file that you have created with the extension CSS has a relation of style sheet with this current HTML web page. Next, the type of page, the type of file that you have created is your text file or your CSS file. Then HREF. HREF, as you know, it creates the link. This attribute will take the value as the name of CSS file. The name with which you have saved your CSS file, the same name will become the value of HREF attribute of link tag. Up till here, am I clear? Immediately raise your thumb if up till here I am thoroughly clear. I am speaking slow so that you people get into know the use of each and every tag. Now, I have taken body BG color silver. My background should be silver. Now here I have taken the table tag and very normally I have created the table. I have done no formatting. I simply take all the necessary tags. I haven't done any formatting over here. Simple table tag, simple TR tag, simple TH tag, simple TD tag. Am I clear? Now, I want your focus on one point. Just keep into your mind the name of CSS file, sample.css. Now we are going to create a separate file where we will apply all the necessary formatting properties to our tags in HTML. I show you that file also. This is my CSS file. I have saved this file with the name sample.css. This file has been saved with the name sample.css. Now see here. First of all, I have taken the select. Here you are not to take any HTML body. No. Straight away take the tag on which you want to apply the formatting. You straight away take all those tags on which you want to apply CSS properties. Right? First of all, I'm going to apply few properties on table tag. I told you whatever property you apply on the table tag, they apply onto the entire table. But you can give other properties. You can make changes in each row if you want. Now, font family Arial, my whole data in the table will appear in the Arial style, Arial font. Background color of the table is yellow. This is the background color of the table, not of the web page. This is background color of the table, not the background color of the web page. Font size, I have given 40 pixels. Now border width. These are the three very special properties related to border. If you want to highlight or you want to specify the border around your table, you have to take these three special properties which are related to border. First property, border width. In HTML, remember when you used to create table, you used to say table border equal to 4. In HTML, you state like this. In CSS, how to give the size of the border, border hyphen width, and you can give any width over here. The more you increase the value, the more thick the border will become. The more thick the border will become, right? Now here you can give three values in a different way. Thick, thin, medium. So either you give thick, either you give thin, either you give medium, or either you take any numerical value. Accordingly, your border will appear. Now, color of the border. Border color. In HTML, it was one straight word, border color. In CSS, it is hyphenated word, border color. One thing I want to tell you people, beta, in HTML coding, whenever you do HTML coding, do not give space in the attribute name. There is no attribute in HTML where you can give space. I was checking your assignments. Many students have given space. Cell spacing, you give space in between the word. Cell padding, you give space. Border color, you give the space. Don't give space in the attribute name in HTML. There is no attribute in HTML where you can give space between the words. Now, border style. There are 8 type of border styles that you can give. Dashed, dotted, inset, outset, ridge, groove, right? 8 type of different style of borders that you can give. Whatever style you want, you write the name of that style after the border style property, right? Now, then I have format the th tag. Then I have format the th tag. Here I have given color green. Color green means that my header row text will appear in the green color. The color of the text in the header row will appear in green color. Then these are the properties of border that will be applied around the cell in th tag. Right? This border property is for the external border around the table. External border around the table. These border properties are the borders which will appear in the inner side of the table. Suppose I am not giving these properties. I am not giving these properties. You will not see border inside the table. You will see only the border outside the table. Am I clear? Similarly, TD tag. I am giving these three properties in the TD tag. Save this file with the name, with any name, and give extension CSS, right? Now I show the browser view of this. When you are to see the browser view, you only have to click the HTML web page. See this. See carefully the result of the coding that I have created with the help of external style sheet. See the style of border outside the table. See the style of border inside the table. The header row, writer's name and primary gender, they are appearing in the green color. Aurora, technical, Roy, fiction. These are appearing in red color. I give you 1 minute. Carefully observe this browser view of external style sheet. Mayank has raised hand. Yes, Mayank.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, beta.
Sir, मैंने वो पूछना था जो CSS वाली कोडिंग थी उसमें ब्रैकेट th ब्रैकेट थी वो नेसेसरी है मतलब वैसे कोडिंग करनी है
मयंक कैन यू प्लीज स्पीक लाउडर योर वॉइस इज नॉट क्लियरली ऑडिबल टू मी बच्चे
सर मैंने पूछना था कि आपने जो SCSS वाली कोडिंग में ब्रैकेट TH ब्रैकेट डाला हुआ था और ब्रैकेट TD ब्रैकेट डाला हुआ था, वो जरूरी है कि हम सिंपली भी लिख सकते हैं?
You are asking about these brackets which I am shading right now.
Yes, sir.
This is important, beta. This is format of giving property for the selector.
Okay, sir.
These are very important and these are compulsory brackets.
नहीं, मैं पूछ रहा हूँ कि ऐसे ऊपर नीचे ऐसे लिखनी है, formatting ऐसे करने होंगे.
Beta, it is up to you. You can write all properties in one line.
Okay.
By writing in separate lines, it makes very clear to the checker. It gives a very clear view. You can write in one line also. Like for example here. You can write like this also in one line. Then finally close the bracket.
Okay.
Right?
Thank you.
It's okay. No issues. Now again I show the browser view. See here. Now I change the style of the border around the table. I will not touch the HTML web page. I will make changes only in the CSS file and the change will be automatically applied to the HTML file. Like I'm going to give the value here, rich. Rich is also a solid style of the table. I save this file. I go to the browser view. I refresh. You can see the change in the border. I have only given change in the CSS coding. And automatically the change has applied to the HTML web page. Right? Now, suppose I am not giving the borders here. I am not giving border here. Let us see what change will come. See here, see carefully the header row. The border is not visible. You cannot see border around the TH cells. Border is around TD cells. Aurora, Technical, Roy, Fiction. You can see border around these cells, but there is no border around the cells which are enclosed in the TH tag. Am I totally clear? Now you can set the border. I am giving border width 3 pixels. I am giving border color blue. I am giving border style. Ridge. Save your CSS file, go to the browser, refresh. Now notice the change in the border around TH. The border is in style ridge, the border is in 3 pixels, and the border is in blue color. External border red color, internal border 2 different colors. For TD, separate border color. For TH, separate border color. See the level of formatting that you can do in CSS. In how many ways you can format your CSS. Have I made thoroughly clear? Mannath has raised hand. Yes, Mannath. Yes, Mannath, beta.
Sir, अगर हमें दोनों rows color different रखना हो.
Can you please repeat your point again?
Sir, अगर हमें दोनों rows का color different रखना
हो. Both the borders?
Color, rows का color हमें different रखना.
that you can do with the inline style. There you can apply the inline style. Now again I shift it back to the CSS properties. Now next main property is margin. Try to imagine a notebook which has four margins: top, bottom, left, right. Margins are of four types: top, bottom, left, right. How much space appears between margin and your text? How much your text is from distance to the margin? When you write in the notebook, you start somewhat ahead from the left margin. You leave some space from the left margin, then you start writing your text. Similarly, you leave some space from the top side, you leave some space from the bottom side, you leave some space from the right side. Whenever you type in MS Word, there also you specify the margins, right?